Hold it, Fred. We don't have any train. We're going on the Newfoundland CN bus. It was a cold winter's night. Not a star was in sight as we rolled down the hill to Random West on a CNR bus that had caused quite a fuss by replacing the Newfoundland Express. In a seat in the rear sat a lad who was here. How long will it take to make the dash? Old Macmillan, they said, a promotion would get if he hustles to save our railroad cash. In a seat just ahead sat a lady in red, Maggie Hawkins from Upper Gully's flat. She weighed 23 stone and the bus gave a groan as she stood up and started for the bag. It was Maggie's intent as the floorboard she bent to enter the powder room and back. It was a small 2x4 with a hatch for a door situated beneath the luggage rack. Now all the crowd gave a roar as she opened the door, and old Maggie to force herself she tried. But at last she got stuck like a Lundrigan truck. It was plain that she'd never get inside. She went back to her seat, dripping sweat in the heat, saying, oh, how I missed the good old train. And if this thing doesn't part until way after dark, my poor kidneys will never stand the strain. Said a man turning pale, she's been drinking hag ale. Give her first aid, it surely is a crime. Old Macmillan jumped up in the aisle and did shout, keep her moving, we're making record time. For an hour they drove till outside Arnold's Cove. Old Maggie, she started for the door. With his stopwatch in his hand, Lord Macmillan took his stand, told the driver to put her to the floor. Now with a final last shriek, Maggie sucked in her cheek, and a great burst of fire and of steam. And a thunderous roar shook the valley and the shore, and the bus blew apart beside a stream. There were 23 men when the rescue squad came. Not a shred of old Maggie could be seen. Old Macmillan went blind, one poor man blew his mind, and the driver woke up in Lameline. Well, on the crest of the hill, just outside Clarenville, stands a tombstone to mark old Mag's remains. May her soul ever fly to that bathroom in the sky. She's the lady that gave us back our train.